Newsham Park Hospital in Liverpool, England is known worldwide as the site of an extremely dark and negative haunting. Katrina and I have been researching this building for years, both anticipating and dreading the chance to someday step inside and experience it for ourselves. Originally built in 1874 as the Royal Liverpool Seamen's Orphanage, it held the orphans of the city's many sailors lost at sea. Over the next 75 years, life was tough for the thousands of children there, with siblings routinely separated and cruel punishments for those that didn't follow the strict rules. Hundreds of children died there, many never knowing another home. It became a hospital in 1954, then a psychiatric asylum in 1992. During this time, it held some of the country's criminally insane, including the horrific serial killer Ian Brady, convicted of torturing and murdering five children in the 1960s. Now, as the 99,000 square foot building sits abandoned, it has reportedly become a well-known sanctum for restless spirits. Shadow figures, phantom apparitions, and disembodied voices are a regular occurrence, and some former employees simply refuse to return.
My name is John Gray, and I started work at Park Hospital in 1973. And I was glad to leave that place. It is most haunted and evil.
Now, after hearing years of reports from the former orphanage in Newsham Park, Katrina and I will finally spend 72 hours investigating the dark haunting here to determine what makes Newsham Park Hospital one of the United Kingdom's most notoriously haunted locations.
Did you just come into this room?
It's night two, we're in the basement, and we're using the motion-activated light panels on the ground with a hazer and lasers so we can see if we can indicate anything crossing this threshold of the door. And also, we have a still camera set up on a tripod so we can try to document any shadow figures or anything that's unexplainable in this area right here.
I'm messing with you.
Oh, you're messing with us?
Look at that. Look at that.
Oh my God.
Everything is really calm, and all of a sudden, the motion-activated light sensors trigger like there's something right above it, and it lights up the whole entire room.
I like the lights you have set up.
Oh.
Yes. Can you move through this haze? Can you try to appear in front of us right here so we can see you? We can't see you, but...
Whoa.
That was crazy.
That's kind of cool.
Are you here? Whoa. I see something like forming out of the haze. Is the camera still snapping?
Yeah, it is. I'm just checking it to see if anything shows up.
I lost my head. It just goes, I lost my head.
Paul talked about seeing a solid figure. Are we actually documenting this negative presence that people have been talking about?
What happened? Did you get in an accident? Was your head cut off by an accident that happened down here?
Whoa.
See, look, did you see that?
I saw that.
And do you think we have it on camera? Yeah, we do.
I mean, we'll definitely have it on our cameras.
This is awesome. Let's keep talking to them.
As we're asking questions, these light panels just light up so distinctly that it's undeniable that this is an intelligent communication coming through.
That was you? Am I talking to this person who lost their head? Whoa, right there.
I saw it. How did you lose your head? What is
sod?
Sod?
It said sod. It was sawed off?
Someone sawed off your head?
Can you tell us what your name is? Sid.
Sid came through again?
That was really clear.
Sid?
So we have a name. His name's Sid. Communicate with us.
Sid, if this is you who we're talking to, do me a favor. Every time the answer to a question is yes, make all those lights light up really bright like you've been doing.
Were you brought here? Were you one of the mental patients?
Ooh, yeah. Oh. So do you think it was mental? You just started to ask that question and it went off.
You were brought here. Were you a patient here? Whoa.
Okay. So yes,
wow.
Yes, you're a patient.
Yes, I was a patient.
Okay.
I think it's referring to something happened because it said saw too.
Right.
So maybe they sawed his head off.
Oh, like an accident?
Or during an autopsy, an accident, something happened here. Did you follow your body down here to the freezer? That went off,
yeah.
Right? Were you murdered? Did someone hurt you with a saw?
Sid, where'd you go?
This is so weird and just like went away for a second. That was really strong communication to something that was extremely intelligent. I swear at one point in the haze, I saw something for me.
I think we both thought we were seeing the same thing.
Right?
It's like towards this corner. To me, it looked like it was almost like this like round ball that started forming.
Exactly. That's
exactly what I saw. But it was like a little misshapen.
Since we're getting this activity down here, mm-hmm. right above us is the main hall. One of us should stay down here, one of us should stay upstairs.
Yeah, I mean, listen, we have a lot of ground to cover. So I think if we split up, set up our cots, go to bed, we do that now, I think it's a good time because things are seeming to want to talk to us.
Perfect, then let's split up right now.
Yeah.
In the morning, let's go through all the pictures that have been snapping right here because what we saw form out of this haze,
yeah.
there has to be something to that. All right, so here's all the pictures from last night during the experiment.
We ended up with about 260.
And we should look for that figure that we both saw kind of growing out of the haze, wasn't it?
Yeah, I saw it like right around here.
Yeah, me too. Oh, that's cool.
Mm-hmm.
The lights light up.
Mm-hmm.
So it must have captured in that moment. Whoa, that's awesome. Look right here.
Yeah.
You can almost see something. Looking at this picture is extremely exciting because it's like discovering a needle in the haystack for paranormal activity. You can clearly see the outline of this figure manifesting, and the camera snapped at the right time to document this. It's incredible.
What the hell is that?
It's really neat.
Like some sort of figure over the top of it, right?
Yeah.
What do you think, honest opinion?
No, I see it. I see it. I absolutely see it. So. I mean, the only things it could be is it's our eyes matrixing mm-hmm. or it's an actual
figure.
Figure.
We document.
We should analyze that and we should keep that in mind for the rest of our investigation.